You know, people who move to South Arlington into the Columbia Pike neighborhood, they know what they're getting. And I've heard from people who've moved around here who have kids, they move here because they want their kids to have the experience of all the ethnicities in their schools. The bit about you can be in an apartment building and you can have an Ethiopian family next to a family from Honduras, next to people from Thailand, etc., etc. And that's unique and cool.
There's always been a very strong, like, immigrant influence here. Like, every one of my neighbors, they were Ethiopian, they were Nigerian, they were Salvadorian, they were Mexican. All of them were immigrants. I didn't know certain parts of Arlington existed until I got older. From 2016 until now, like in 2 years, everything has changed so quickly. Like, Food Star and that Oriental Market that used to be here. But then you couldn't go there anymore because they closed it down.
I believe creating retail centers that are a little bigger than the rest of the Pike, they may include in those retail centers maybe one regional or national brand that sends a message not only to those living on the Pike, but to future small business owners that this is a place that you can come and really do business. And I believe that you can create those anchors without sacrificing the overall community of the startup. I think thriving means to find transportation, destination, so that you can truly have a diverse community. Diverse always means something different to someone else. But if we can have homegrown businesses, culturally diverse street with immigrants and people starting their careers, a place for those who are more established. Unfortunately, those groups don't always connect with each other, or they are fearful of each other, that one or the other will drive the other out. But finding a way to make that happen, I think, is a modern community and one that can thrive in the long run.
The kids have a better life here, more opportunities for the kids at school, out of school, in sports. And I think Arlington is amazing. It's an amazing county. And that gave me my dreams. That can be true for my family and for my community.
Sometimes I forget I'm in America. Like, it's so diverse. I'm like, oh, feels normal. It feels like I'm home. I don't see a type of people alone. I see different type of people. Like, I see Asians, I see Hispanics, I see Blacks, Africans.
In Arlington, that diversity that we have, that we share different cultures, and then it teaching us to be a better human beings because we're learning from everybody. I learned from the people that came from Guatemala, from El Salvador, different cultures. It's, you know, everybody contribute a little bit to make this country a better place to live. You know, without the immigrants, this country is not going to be the country that is.
This was sort of ground zero for Vietnamese or for Southeast Asians in general in the entire United States. And then we started getting a little bit of everything, United Nations. But gradually we got more and more Ethiopians, Eritreans, mm-hmm. and Hispanics.
My dream for this place is a little bit what I think most of us progressives dream for cities in general, right? That it will continue to be a place that welcomes in people from all walks of life and all over the world and provides the kind of community through good jobs, great schools, good transportation, housing that is manageable in price, for them to achieve whatever the good life looks like for them.
You know, when you move to a country, you're not familiar and you're having to learn a new language and custom, and you know, you don't fit in. So I know what it feels like, you know, to be an immigrant, try to find your identity and try to figure things out.
It was shocking, and I like it. I like diversity. I had to adapt. It was a change, like also the way of thinking, like I wonder how they see me. do they see me the same way I see them? And then what they think of me? You know, do they think of me the same way I think of them? So all those were questioned to me, into my mind, as I go about in my daily routine.
Yeah, I've made friends from like the whole world, from Vietnam, from Mongolia, from China, from Ethiopia, my country, from Eritrea. And I love like talking to them because I hear different stories about some stuff from different countries' perspectives, so that's great. When I came here, I expected to just like to stay home and go to school, that's it. I didn't expect to like communicate with my community, and I was kind of scared, I guess, because I was new. But when I came here, everybody was smiling at me, everybody was accepting, so I kind of feel like home, and I didn't feel like I'm alone, so that is a great thing. We as a community can like be whatever we want. We can get anywhere we want if we stay together and stick together. So the love we have can improve our life for better. So
I love Columbia Pike. What I think I like the most is how real it is. Even the guy next door, the Mongolian guy that opened up a computer repair store.
Yeah.
That's awesome. I mean, that's what this country is about.
Because I'm a first-generation American, I'm born and raised here. I consider myself American with strong Ecuadorian and Punjabi Sikh roots. My father considers himself a first-generation Thai with strong Punjabi Sikh roots, and now an American. Being biracial in Arlington, you know, there are more than 100 languages spoken here, and there is a diversity of experiences that I grew up in that are really unique to being in a mixed race family. I think because both of my families have immigration and refugee experiences, I think it makes us very resilient. You know, there's so growing up, you know, there's so much of like just work hard, try hard, you know, luchar.
I think that Americans have this perception that America looks a certain way and it's supposed to sound a certain way, and we are living in a really big experiment. Can you bring people who come from different backgrounds? They're different religions, they're different races, they have different ideological beliefs, and bring them from all over the world, mix them up into this one place and say, can you govern yourselves where you can coexist peacefully and thrive? To come to a place like Arlington that is so diverse, and you see people from all walks of life coexisting peacefully and thriving professionally, in their education, in their personal lives, it does make me feel really hopeful. When we can prove to the world that, hey, you don't have to be homogenous to be harmonious. You can be diverse and still coexist very peacefully, and not just peacefully, but actually appreciate the place that you live in.
I'd have to say, one of my big concerns right now is, and it's on a lot of people's minds, is the development, or some would say gentrification, and many others would say maybe overdevelopment of the Pike, and how we've kicked out Black and Brown-owned businesses, a lot of the Latino-owned businesses, and a lot of the Asian American and Indian-owned businesses on the Pike, and how rental rates keep rising and rising and rising as we continue to densify, and a much wider, younger crowd with, you know, disposable income are able to move in here and take up the apartment complexes.
It seems like there won't be as many immigrants in the Columbia Pike area. I think that eventually, I'd like to hope that like the children, like the people who are my age or the younger, will benefit from the schooling and just living in this area to want to kind of stay in this area and grow with it.